Good morning, everyone. This is Russ Campbell speaking. I'm about to show you what to do to put in a sound card. My sound card is already in from the video before that I made, but I'm not going to show. So I'm going to show you, just pretend that sound card is another card. I'm going to show you how to remove them. First of all, so that you can clean the contact and do everything you need to do. First of all, we'll start with the sound card. Let's say it could be anything. But we're going to remove that first. What you need for the job is you need a pair of needle-nose pliers. You need a pair of tin snips. And, of course, you need the sound card, which I will show you. First of all, this one was put in without the bracket, so we'll just pull it. The machine is unplugged, so it's safe. Now, to get at the video card, there's a little tab you gotta pull. So, I'm gonna get something, maybe a pen or something. Yeah, a pen will do it. And just push in it a little bit and pull it out. Okay, it's come out. Now, some of you may have problems with the slots. I'm going to clean the slots because it's an old machine. What you have to do, the easiest way to do it, and this worked for me, but you have to let it dry for a few seconds. Take an alcohol swab like this one and gently put it in and rub it back and forth. This works. Do the same with the other one. The idea is that you leave just a little bit of alcohol in it. It's going to take a little bit more than that. This one I had problems with too. Do the same, you don't have to, but I'll do the same with my video card, because I've had problems with the video card. Turn it around so you got a little bit of alcohol, and gently clean the contacts. There. It should now work, and give it at least 30 seconds to dry. Contacts for your cards. Because your cards have been in a dirty slot, probably, or maybe dirty in any way, form, or shape, I don't like holding on to the card like this, but it's necessary for the video. Take the alcohol swab and you clean the contacts. Okay, let's wait for that to be done. Same for the video card. This one looks pretty clean, but we're gonna do it anyways. Okay, that'll prevent any problems from occurring. Now, well, that is, we're going to take the card. You have to take it off the card to measure it. There it is in there. I'm going to take a marker. Incidentally, a marker like this is fine, but a Sharpie would be better. I don't have a Sharpie. and there's already marks on it, but I'll do it again. So, to cut it with a 10 snip. Now, I've never done this before, so I don't know whether it'll work. I'm going to do it over this piece of paper. Still over the piece of paper. Cut it part way. Yeah, I see it. I'm going to have to do this off camera. And it works properly. I don't want to hold it over the machine, but there it's been cut off. Where'd that piece go? Okay. Okay, we'll find the piece later. Now with bare needle nose pliers, this is why you gotta take it off the I'm holding it over the machine because I got the camera sitting on it. You just bend it a little bit. Again, I'm going to have to do this off camera, but that's not bad. And check and see if it fits snugly. This is up and off. Put it back in. Okay, this is wrong. It should be right above. I'm gonna have to cut more off. See the mistakes I made? You want to measure here instead of here. So we'll do it again. It's bent. That's why I only cut a little bit off. So. Again, we mark it where we're going to bend it. And we mark it where we're going to cut it. That'll be about right. Okay. I'm going to do this off camera. I don't want to get the piece in the... Okay, put it back in to see if it's longer. It is. So what we have to do is bend it just a little bit. That piece went flying into the machine. So I'm going to have to take a look and see if I can find it. I don't know where it went. I have to find that piece. I know where it is. I'm not doing anything until I find it. Here it is, right here. Okay, there's the piece that did not go into the machine. That's the one piece. And that's the other piece from the first one. So we know it's not in the machine. Now to bend it. Yeah, I have to bend it just right, and I can't do it on camera. This is why you have to take the bracket off. I guess I could have done it on camera. Anyways, that's not bad. There's the result. Now that should fit in snugly. If it doesn't, you have to bend it back. Okay. Okay, it's a little too high. Again, we have to bend it a little more. I think that the top of this lines up. That's why you gotta take the card off, or the piece off. Now the top of that lines up with it. This bracket lines up with the top, so you gotta bend it flush. So I'm gonna show you this on camera. You bend it back. Don't want to break it. Takes two hands, so I gotta do it on off camera. I'm going to have to cut a little bit off so it matches. Sometimes it takes a little bit to do it. That's why I'm doing it off camera so I don't get anything in the machine. Just the way I have it set up. Okay. This is not bad. Here's what we've got. There's a half height bracket. It's not perfect. I'm going to take the pliers and squeeze out a bit. Cutting a little hole, you need a Dremel or something, but here's the result. It fits. Except it's going to go over here. Now we need to bend that down just a little bit. Will it still close with it? No, it won't. So it needs to be bent down more. But now the floss should be dry. Try it again to make sure it closes. Yes, it closes, it makes good contact. Now we're going to put the pieces back together. I'm going to show you this on camera. I don't like to hold it this way, but this is how you do it. First of all, I'm going to put the screws in. Take it like this, there's mountings, and you put the screws in carefully and the nuts and washers. That I'm going to have to do off camera because I don't want to lose any nuts or washers in it. It's too easy to lose them in the case. One fell off already while I was doing it on my leg. You have to do it away from the computer. There are certain things I can show, and there are certain things that I just can't show. This is one of them. And this thing has fallen 3 times now. Where it would be a disaster. Use the opposite to put it back on, look it up on YouTube. But it should be easy. Washer on the floor or on the seat of my chair. It was on the seat of my chair. It's a very tricky thing to put back on. Now for part two, putting back in the sound card and the video card. It's not too hard. I'll show you how to do it. I've already put the bracket back on. I could not do it on camera because the computer camera is over the computer. So in this case, hold it like this. That's the proper way. Mount it. Still gonna have to get in there somehow. This has to come up. Okay. Still gonna have to hold it this way to do it. This is just a little bit too high. But it's not bad. And snap it in place. Now for the video card. Again, you have to hold it. It is tricky to put in. This is a modified card. I don't like doing it like this because I... There. Okay, make sure that it's in the slot. Don't force it. It should snap in nice and easily. This one's giving me grief. Okay. I'll put it down here, stand over it, and make sure that it goes in right. Okay, it's going in. That's in. Now make sure the machine fires up once you put in the other card. I'm going to have to adjust this so that this stays on. I only have the one controller, one piece, so maybe I have another one. And put it in. Actually, before you put it, yeah, you have to put it in first. And hope everything works. Now the Peronino fires, I can tighten that up so it does not come loose. Should have the other one in. There, that's tight enough. Adjust it, so I'm not going to use it anyways, but put it in. Your best to get the right piece. I don't have one, so now this you have to make sure it goes in right. Takes two hands sometimes. There. Okay, that video, that sound card or the video card is not in all the way. Okay. Now it's in. Fire up the machine, and as long as it boots up, before I do that, I have to plug it in and plug in the cable. Okay, plug the machine in. I hopefully everything will work. And power it on. Okay, I guess the lights light up and the machine comes on. I'm going to end it here, show you the rest of it. I did not get an error about the I/O card, so that's good. Thank you. Okay, this is the sixth part of the video. They'll all be put together. What you have to do first, once you've got the sound card in, you have to go to the internet. You go on Google Chrome, which I use most of the time. There is a number on the card which you should have written down. I didn't do, but I've already got it written down. It's 0570 SB0570. We've already got the files, but I'm going to show you how to download them. So you go to Google. You've got it in Google, and you search for SB0570 or whatever card you have. That's what we want. Now there's two files you have to download, not just one. Here it is here, Sound Blaster out of GSE. You have to find the right one. So go right down to where it is. And if you have Windows 64, 10-bit 64, you can do it. I have Windows 8 64, and I want both the application. What is this? That's drivers. I don't know why it's in that language. So submit. Okay. That is drivers. We'll download the application first. Submit. That is 7.4 megabytes. 6 plus 3 is 9. Agree. So we have that one there. Now we need to go back. Q fill this part. That's the right way to do it. I don't know why it's in this language. Application. Let's check this out. Okay, I know that's drivers. Submit. Yes. That's 40 megabytes. You need the drivers too. You install the drivers first. 9 plus 2 is 11. It's a recaptcha. Agree. Again, I'm going to put all these videos together to make one video. It'll be long, but it won't be that long. Oh, we downloaded it twice. Okay. So, kill that. Now what we do, I've already got WavePad Sound Editor. Depends on what you want. If you want Mixcraft, you have to download it. It's $90. Let's see what it's worth, just so you know. Pro Studio. Let's see what it's on for right now. $131 Canadian, US 99. If you already have Mixcraft, you probably get a deal on it. Anyways, downloading that is easy. They can give you a demo of it. I think. On sale now. Let's see what the sale price is. Now $79, so it's not bad. It's a good price. System requirements. Here's what you need. I've got 8 gigabytes RAM, so there's no problem. You get Melodyne with it. I'll show you all that when we get over to it. But we're not going to download that one. You guys can do that. I'm going to show you how to download the other software that can need. Let's get rid of this. These stupid things keep popping up. So we want WavePad free download. I've already got it. Download it. There you go. If you already know, I'll show you. You probably already know how to install it. But let's first of all, I'm going to use Total Commander. It's the easiest one to get. It shows everything. Okay. The last one that I downloaded. Was number 5. And somewhere is the other one. There's the Mixcraft setup. there somewhere. Well, what I'll do is with this one you can show the date of everything. There it is. There's the Sound Blaster software. First of all, you install the drivers. This will be the same for any drivers you use. Put it in English or whatever language you want. Well, it's automatically running the Alchemy one. Think. Next. I'm going to end up having to reboot it, so I'll have to continue after the reboot. You also have to configure the sound card so that the turntable matches and no hum and audio hiss. I recommend using not your caller's record player. I have no choice because it's the only one I have. I have another one, but it does not have an audio output. And the only way to record with it is through a mic. So I have no choice. But if you have a choice, go out and get a USB record player. It's a lot easier. The one that I have is a Philp model, can't remember what it is. Okay, it says restart the computer. Gonna restart it now. The next part here is running the Total Commander again. We may have to reboot again, but I will do that. Okay, now you have to run the 42 one. I'm going to run the latest version. They're both the same one. Okay, this part is the Creative Software Auto Update. It's in the program. I'm hoping we got the part before, but if not, then it's easy to install. Okay, it's check update. All right. I do believe we have to close this off. Now, I'm going to, first of all, let's turn the record player on. Gotta plug it in first. And we need to check it. To do this, we go into the control panel. Right now, it's probably set just right. In fact, we're going to put a record on. The one's called record. Okay, we're going to put it on so there's some music. This has not been set up. adjust the record player a little bit. So we have to go to control panel. Control panel, it's set for other stuff. So go into sound. Okay, it's set on speakers. We want to set it on SB Audigy, make it default. And this one, actually the speakers, we want to set as default communication device. And this one set as your default device. There you go. In order for the SB Audio to work, we go into levels and line in has been turned off. So 24 would be about right. Custom. Okay. We want to make it so you can hear it. Properties. It's working okay. Okay, we have to troubleshoot this. Are you going to know how to do that? Well, that's speaker. Recording. Here we go. Turn it, listen device. Take it down a little bit. Do not monitor. Turn that on. Listen needs to be turned on. Advance. That's fine. Apply it. Re-cue the record so we have some sound going through it. Could be because I'm using the microphone. Okay, here's the trick to getting everything working. I am pretty sure that you have to plug something into the Sound Blaster card, like a speaker of some sort. So that's what I'm going to do. Because it has to be activated in some way. Get the cord I need for it. Or headphones. Here it is. We'll use the speaker so you can hear that it works. Okay, now we'll try it. Something is definitely wrong. Something's wrong here. This is the troubleshooting part.
Thank you.
Hello everybody. I'm going to show you the last part of my video. The getting the sound card to work. So we go in here on Windows 8 or Windows 10, it doesn't matter. And I'm going to set it back the way it was. You go into sound. Right now it's set up properly. We'll put a record on. So it's now set up properly, but let me show you where it is. If you want to have it go to the computer, first of all, you have to set up playback, speakers, custom levels. You have to have the line in turned on. I'll set the playback a little louder. Sound blaster is all set up, advanced. 16-bit DVD quality is fine. Properties. I'm going to show you where you can get the stuff that you set up. Go to recording, line in, custom. Okay, when you go to play back through your device, you can set it for speakers, USB headphone speaker, set it for your TV. That'll give you the sound. You also have to set the custom up, do not monitor, find the way it is, listen to this device. Advanced, okay. Apply that. That's the settings you have to have. As you can see, it's the microphone from the USB headset is working right now, but I can still play it. There's not much hiss in that. Very little. Okay, so that's about it. Thank you.